Hey friends, here's a good old ace drag for you. Let's talk about my try to stream yesterday. Something cool that one of you created for me. And no, we are not talking about the Carrack, because firstly there are enough videos from the PTO on the subject. And secondly, I would like to do a tour on the Carrack by myself, if it goes live. No, let's talk about the roadmap patch 4.1. Finally, the roadmap has been expanded and I will not only list the points, but also talk about some with you. If you might have noticed it yesterday, I wanted to stream on Twitch. But the test did not go well and I will have to deal with the setting again. Are you interested in a live stream? Then one of you, the good ANPV, sent me a design for my own dog tag. I think it's great. Thank you, and I will surely use it. Before I get to the roadmap, if you like my video, subscribe to my channel. And every minute of my videos you watch helps the channel to grow. If you want to support me directly, you will find the link to my Patreon page in the description below. Now we come to the roadmap and the first block, AI. Here we see the 2 points, FPS realistic weapons handling and combat improvement and polishing, which makes me hope that the AI will finally show us a fighting behavior in the FPS area. The second point, ship AI hazard awareness and avoidance, is interesting for me. Not because of the point that the AI avoid heavily guarded zones, but because of the ATC. Maybe that means that dangerous flight zones are not even as far away as I thought. There had been hints in the video Star Citizen Live Adventures in Spaceships, where it has been said that the aerodynamics of ships in atmospheres is important for dangerous flights across storms, or better said that it will be easier than with a non-aerodynamic shaped ships. Maybe this will come this year. I thought maybe next year. What do you think? Feel free to write a comment below the video. But let's go further. Now we come to the gameplay. There we have improved throw, which maybe means that we can finally use grenades and not kill ourselves with it. When was the last time you tried to use a grenade? Hopefully, object push and pull will open up some interesting opportunities. So far we only have moving small objects in the game. So I'm excited to see what comes. The last point under gameplay, missile operator mode, will surely please everyone who has mixed rocket magazine. So far I always find it frustrating that you don't really have the full control over the rockets and you can only shoot the magazine empty. And now we come to the definitive point that will make some pilots out there happy. Jared said it last week in the Star Citizen Live, but it is different when you see it on the roadmap yourself. The Mercury Starrunner is now official on the roadmap. We are shortly now before the first Crusader ship release in the world. It is a pity that it is not the Hercules, but I'm still happy about it, hopefully that nothing delay it. I hope that some of you will be happy about it. The last block of the roadmap is weapons and items. Anyone who already knows my channel will know that I usually pay little attention to this category. But this time it is different. The Behring GP-33 grenade launcher, it is not. I just check it off. But the Grey Cat FPS multi-tool cutting attachment is a different matter. According to the description, the tool allows us to cut and shape specific objects. So what is in store for us now? The first version of salvaging as an FPS introduction? Or repairing our ships on our own? Maybe it's just about breaking open locked doors and cupboards. What's your opinion? I'm curious what you think about it. That's it for today. Until next time, I'll strike.